The Purge Anarchy. The Purge Anarchy is about... It is not the sequel to The Purge 1. The Purge Anarchy is about... As you see in the trailer, these couple get stranded, but it's more than that. There's a character who's part of a poor family, who is this poor black family, and you see this girl works in a diner as a waitress. She has a daughter, and she's got skeevy guys that hit on her at work and stuff like that. Still a normal, you know, attractive, middle-aged, whatever have you, woman. So, basically, we got the dad. He's very sick. To help the daughter and the mom, his daughter and his granddaughter, they have, he gets bought as a martyr for thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands of dollars. Very, very much moolah. And so they end up freaking out about that. Then they find out that the there's these soldier-like people that end up breaking into her home, and she ends up getting out where it's unsafe. And there's this one guy who wants to do his own thing with the purge. He wants exact revenge. He's got a vendetta against this one guy. So basically, he's on the hunt, and he finds these women. So he helps them, and they owe him a debt of gratitude. So he's like escorting them to help them from danger. And basically, all these people are going up against him. You got this motherfucker with a Gatling gun. You got these dudes with blades. You got dudes with automatic rifles. You got dudes with snipers up on the rooftops. Shit goes crazy. But then there's this one dude that's kind of like a Black Panthers-like guy. He's against it. So he wants to stop the purge. He believes the purge is just, you know, the people who benefit from the purge are people that are rich, who can afford weapons and stuff, and it's basically to rid of the poor, that it's his belief. So he ends up, he does a lot of televised broadcasts and stuff to communicate to the people about how wrong the purge is. So he also believes that the purge is basically the government taking advantage of us in a time when we were really, really like about to crumble as a foundation, as a nation. And so there's this long journey, this long crazy thing with this guy. This couple ends up finding this guy who was exacting revenge on this one other dude who killed his son. And the mother and the daughter are with him for protection. And yeah, it's a lot of crazy stuff. It's pretty nuts. It's a lot better than the first one. I really liked it. This movie was about an hour and 45 minutes. Let's see here. It does have some intense parts. It's not like gore. It can be bloody, but it is Very violent. I think they're trying to make it more and more intense. And the ending's great. The cast does a great job. They're all very emotional, very, a lot of, you can feel a lot of their just power. When they're in shock or terror or fear, they just, you really feel it and you get chills. It's a really good movie. If you like movies that are intense, I guess you could kind of call it a thriller. It's not a horror, but it is a good movie. Definitely go see The Purge Anarchy. It's really, 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 really good. Yeah, that's The Purge Anarchy. Good fucking movie. And I really enjoyed it. Saw my friend Amber, and we liked it a lot. Okay, that's The Purge Anarchy. And I will see you later.